I'm Wahid from Afghanistan. I'm a Beijing-based entrepreneur and community builder. I came to China back in 2014. I started doing my bachelor's in University of International Business and Economics. And currently our startup is focusing on building hubs across BRI countries and then connecting them through our matchmaking and media platforms.
Многие иностранцы, кто приезжает в Китай на учебу, также мечтают остаться здесь поработать после выпуска из университета. Кто-то устраивается в компании, кто-то открывает свой бизнес, а кто-то уезжает домой, так и не найдя здесь свое призвание. Но гостю нашей сегодняшней программы удалось открыть 3 компании и даже выиграть в нескольких конкурсах стартапов. В настоящее время он занимается тем, что помогает таким же недавним студентам и не только с поиском работы и открытием своего бизнеса. Давайте у него узнаем, как ему это удалось.
Hello, Ahead.
Hello, Anastasia.
Why did you choose China as your place to start a career?
Honestly, I never thought about starting a career in China. It all went so natural. I came to China for a study. I was doing my bachelor's. I was approached by my classmates and friends, and they said, hey, we actually are working on this startup. Do you want to join? And I said, yes, why not? So I joined that, and it was a very international environment, but that was how I started it. But that's not enough for me. I think why I continue staying in China or why I'm still in China, that matters the most is because it's such an inclusive ecosystem, especially for foreigners. A lot of people from outside, they might not understand it, but it's a very inclusive, it's a very peaceful community in here. And the amount of support that you're gonna get from your surroundings, from your friends, from everybody, makes life very, very easier. Makes creating, building companies very, very easier.
I know that your first startup was about education. So how did that idea come to your head?
Me and a couple of classmates, we had a trip to Gansu. And that time we went to one of the, you could say it's like a very remote place. When we saw the kids, they were so inspiring over there. They were brilliant, they were studying the whole day. They were so passionate about learning. They were so passionate about exchanging with us. And when I came back to Beijing, I told my friends, like, there's a lot of excitement for people to know more about the world, to about other countries. And that's why we started the UFO International Cultural Education Company. And when we started that, the first thing we did is, like, we're gonna try to teach children about more countries. We're gonna teach them about more cultures. And we hope that by teaching them this culture, they will understand that culture. They will have empathy toward that culture. They will resonate with that culture. And in future, because they will be the future leaders if they go and engage with them. And just because they have this understanding already, just because they can resonate with them, it will be easier for them to engage in. It will be easier for them to communicate with. And it will be easier for them to create value on an international level. So that was a very inspiring and a very fulfilling journey for me.
How did your previous experience, the one that you're talking about, help you with what you're doing now?
Almost in every aspect. It changed my life. It made me a better person. UFO was such a wonderful journey. Because when we started UFO, we didn't have a lot of people in the team, so I had to do the finances, marketing, assistant, even translating, hosting, pushing the chairs and everything. It's funny, even by now I talk with my friends and I teach my Chinese entrepreneur friends, is like, do you know about Wuxi and Yijin? You really need to get Wuxi and Yijin for your employees. So that was really like, you know, I learned everything about how to start a business, how to manage a business.
I know that you raised the money for your startups in the startup competition. So how was it taking part in the competition as a foreigner? Do you think that it was challenging, or on the contrary, it was easier for you because you were foreign and you basically stood out?
Well, I think I would say both of them. So first of all, I think being a foreigner in a startup competition is actually quite an advantage. When you get there, there's like excitement, like, oh wow, we have a foreigner in here. But there is a lot of challenges that you, now if you go on the stage, you need to be able to express your ideas or like present your ideas in a very clear way, and you need to be very good in Chinese. Because majority of the time, the judges you are engaging with, they will probably not understand if you explain everything in English. So it's both challenging, but it's also, it gives you this extra point of being like, you know, everybody paying extremely attention to you. So that's one thing. But entrepreneurship competitions are a very good way for you to go and practice your pitching, for you to know more about your business model. So just being taking a part in it, it's already a win for you. Competitions right now, it's not based on, oh, who's going to get the first prize, oh, who's going to get the second prize. There's a little bit for everything. You get there, you might find the right teammate over there. You might find the right investor in the audience. You might actually get some feedbacks from other people. My whole business is built based on a competition.
Apart from being an entrepreneur, you're actually a community builder. So what does it mean for you to be a community builder, and why do you think is it important to take part in the communities and actually, you know, build them, build this ecosystem?
We build communities majority of the times to bring people together, to engage in discussions. And through these discussions, we're able to harvest creativity. And those creativity is like a catalyst for entrepreneurs to make their business better, to stand out. But at the same time, it also helps everybody over there. It helps their surroundings. Through our communities, we were able to provide job opportunities for more than 200 foreigners. We still have group chats of like around 400-500 people, and they're applying for internships opportunities there too. So I think community is a very good place for people to explore opportunities, and that's why we always create these communities to explore opportunities ourselves and also help everybody else do that too.
Right, you are very passionate about your work. Where do you get your inspiration from? Because this is not actually for everyone, right?
That's a really amazing question. I think passion doesn't come from outside. It's an output from your inside, right? But in order to have the passion, we need to go back to the basics. As my new company is a very good example. Youfoo, we stopped it because of COVID, and I was sitting in my room and I said, like, wait, what should I do? Should I get a job? And I checked out my CV and I was like, that's a horrible CV, I will never get a job. I said, all right, so what I should do? That was the first question I came to me, so I wrote it down. Then the next question that came to me is like, oh wait, what I can do? And I realized that what I should do and what I can do, there's a big difference between them. Then I said, wait, these are the good things, what I should do, what I can do, but what do I want to do? And these three things are gonna help me have a vision. And once you have a vision, there's a faith about it. You know, the image comes and you look at the image and you know that's 100% possible. So when you look at it as possible and you have this vision, that's where the passion comes from. And then you're gonna work hard for it. And then you're gonna be inspired by your own self-awareness. You're gonna be inspired by the image that you see.
China is a very dynamic country, especially economically wise. In the latest years, there were 21 free trade zones open in different cities in China. And actually, one of the latest is the one that we are currently right now,
yes.
The Beijing CBD. So can you tell me a little bit about the entrepreneurship atmosphere here in Beijing? Assess a little bit the entrepreneurship environment.
So very interesting question. Actually, so Beijing has a pilot free trade zone right now located in Chaoyang district, and it has two parts. The first part is actually in CBD, which focus much more on financials and financial sector. And then there's also a new part of it, they call it Jinjiang, International Cooperation Service Zone. And just by having this international service cooperation, it means China's opening doors. It means China is giving signals to entrepreneurs from all across the world to come. There's a lot of like good policies in place. There's a lot of good talent programs put in place for people to come and get it started, and there's a lot of inclusive ecosystems are actually built within this free trade zones, and we are a part of these ecosystems. And again, it goes back to the sphere we were talking, right? So the policy is free trade zone, and now there's two ecosystems, which is Jinjiang and CBD. We're working on a community called Alumni Talent Alliance, and Alumni Talent Alliance is to empower talents to start up a business or to get a job in China or even to engage with anything Chinese related. And then on top of that is the startups, that how we're gonna empower startups to our communities. And then hopefully these startups will go on, create international value. So yeah, just by having this policy, that completes our layers, that completes our triangle, and that's gonna create value on a very exponential way, because it just keep growing and growing. And it makes China more inclusive, and it provides more opportunities. And this free trade zone is also focusing much more on service trades. So not only you need to sell goods and stuff, you don't need to sell stuff anymore, but you can actually have a very good service and be a part of it.
Yeah, so how hard is it to be a foreign entrepreneur in China? Because this environment is actually very culturally challenging for foreigners.
It is quite easy. It's really easy. I think it's easier than getting a job. I think the word inclusive I have probably brought up like 20 times already. Just by having this world of inclusive, open, transparent, supportive, these are the words that's usually been thrown out like by a lot of people in our communities in here, because it is actually there. As long as you have a good idea, there's a lot of communities, policies, ecosystems. Everybody's going to come together to support you.
What is the advantage of setting up a business in China compared to other countries?
First of all, it's a humongous market. It's a humongous market, and China is way more international than people can think. First of all, you will be able to engage on a whole international level, but you will also have access to the biggest market in the world. So that's one of the reasons why you should start a business in China. That's the first thing. Then the second thing is about policy-wise. You have free trade zones that are going to give you a lot of tax exemptions. And right now, it doesn't matter if you're a Chinese-owned company or a foreign-owned company. You're able to apply for the same kind of grants. You have equal opportunities too. So that makes it even better. And the third thing is, we could say it's a metropolis. There's a lot of talents in here. This is the best place for you to have access to a lot of good facilities, right? So it makes everything very simple. It's quite simple. That's why a lot of foreigners are actually choosing this place. And also, I think right now these free trade zones are becoming these ports, international ports, for where actually the information, the talent, and resources and everything will be exchanged between countries on a higher level. And that brings a lot of value to entrepreneurs as well.